In this video, we're going to build a social media app like Reddit or Hacker News using Lovable, and we're going to connect it to Supabase, so it's going to have a backend and it can be used on the web. So let's start by saying I want to build a social media app similar to Hacker News with user accounts, upvoting, commenting, and posting. And so let's go ahead and generate this. And it's going to start on the left side with kind of a chat. And then on the right side, it's going to be spinning up the preview and starting the generation. A couple things I'm going to point out here. On the top right, in Lovable, you can connect to your GitHub repository. And that's how you can edit the code, which is a little bit different from Bolt. In Bolt, you can edit the code directly. But in Lovable, you have to connect to GitHub. It's pretty easy, and then you can make changes directly from GitHub. We're going to be using the Supabase integration later on to actually add the backend database. So they make their database integration really, really easy. And then also we're going to be using the publish button later on to actually publish our app so that anyone can use it on the internet. So it's gone through and kind of come up with a design inspiration, some features for the first version, design elements, and here we go. We're about to see the first version with just a very simple prompt. So this is pretty cool. Let's play around with it. I see a few posts that it created for us to kind of interact with. Let's see if I click on the post, if it works. It looks like it may not have actually created that post. So let's go back to the index. Let's see, upvoting, it seems to be working. Can I create a post? So that one doesn't seem to be working as well. So let's give it a few more prompts. So I'm going to say, please make the post page visible slash work, as well as the create post page. The post page should have all the comments and the ability to comment and upvote comments, and the create post page should have all functionality necessary to create a post. So I'm going to pause the video and let it generate that. So there was an error that Lovable saw, and then there's a button that pops up that just allows you to try it to fix the issue automatically. So now Lovable is analyzing the errors and working on fixing those issues. Okay, so we're back on the index page. It looks like it fixed the errors because now I can click into the page, and I like how there's a little kind of animation that you can see that happens to elements on the page when it loads, and then it shows comments. The commenting isn't actually working yet. The create post page as well. The create post doesn't actually work either. But overall, this is looking really, really nice already. So let's say next, I want to integrate this with Supabase. So to do this, first of all, I'm gonna click on Supabase. I've already created a Supabase account. So you have to do that first. I'm gonna go over to that real quick. So here, I've created a Supabase account. You can do this for free. You can create two projects for free. So I'm going to create a new project under the No Code MBA organization. The project will be the Lovable social media app. You can put in a password. Doesn't really matter right now. And then I'll go ahead and create a new project. And it just takes a second to actually load the project. So I'm going to pause the video, let it finish setting up the project, and then once that's set up, we'll be able to access it directly from Lovable. Okay, so the project is set up within a Supabase, so now I'm going to go connect to a project, and it's the Lovable social media app that we just created, and I'm going to say connect. And here we go. It's going to say now we're going to gather the database structure, tables, and security settings. So it's going to do all this to generate the tables to add to the Supabase backend. All right, so here I can see it says my app is now connected to Supabase, and it says it added user accounts and login. It added storing and using real data and advanced features like edge functions. It also said before you deploy your app for production, make sure you set up the appropriate policies. Okay, so let's go back to Supabase for a second. So here in my project, if I go to the table editor, let's just refresh. So it doesn't look like the tables were created yet. So I'm going to go back in a second to do that. Yeah, it doesn't look like any tables were created. But I want to go to authentication. I want to go to providers. Under email, I'm going to uncheck confirm email. So I don't want to worry about sending an email confirmation right now. So I'm just going to save to take away that requirement. And then let's go back to Lovable. Okay, cool. Oh, I see. So this is saying actually what it can do, not that it did do. So it only connected to the Supabase projects first. Okay, so I'm going to say I want to add user accounts to post or comment, but also want unauthenticated users to be able to view the content. I also want to save the content or save the posts and comments in the database. So let's see what it does to take care of all those things. So off the bat, it is generating the code to add the tables to the to our Supabase. So I'm going to just click apply changes here. Now, this is something that in Bolt currently, you have to copy this and put it into Supabase. It's pretty easy to do, and I think Bolt is working on making it more seamless, just like Lovable does. But Lovable makes it really easy right now, where you can just click apply changes, and then it's going to create the tables. So now it's going to apply the code to integrate authentication and database storage for posts and comments to actually make use of those tables that it just generated. All right, so I was running into some errors, and the next thing I'm trying is to say to get rid of the mock data and only show real data, because I'm getting some errors when I'm clicking into the mock data to test it out. So here, it removed the mock data. Now it says no real posts or no posts yet. So let's see if creating a post works. Hello world, and create the post. Okay, so I'm gonna say, I created a post, but it's not showing up on the feed. So let's see if it's able to fix this. All right, so let's try again. First post, hello world, create post. All right, there we go. First post, posted by anonymous. So it doesn't have the authentication yet set up, because it was really only supposed to be able to post if I created an account. It looks like I can upvote. Can I comment? First comment. Must be logged in to comment. Okay. So we're getting closer. So what I want to do is only allow logged in users to post. In addition to commenting, if logged out, show a pop-up modal to log in or sign up. Okay, so let's see how it does with that. All right, so let's see if it successfully did this. If I click create post, it's gonna have a modal, awesome. Log in or sign up. Before I do that, let's go back to this post and see if the same thing happens with a comment. Awesome, okay, great. So log in or sign up, don't have an account, sign up. So let's create an account real quick. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and sign up. And let's see if it worked, because it might be an issue where, so now I'm logged in. Okay, cool. So small issue, after successfully signing up or logging in, close the modal. Also show the user's signed an email on the top right nav. Okay, so there was just a small usability issue there, but it works. So now let's see if I can create a new post. Hello, create post, awesome. And I can upvote. Okay, cool. This is coming along pretty well. All right, so let's see. The login mode will now automatically close after authentication, and the email will be displayed in the top right. Says the build was unsuccessful. I'll say try to fix it and go back. All right, so looks like it doesn't have my account. So why don't I say add account page and button to access account if logged in. So let's see if it handles that prompt a little bit better. All right, so I still didn't see it, so I just asked it again, and I think it's going to add it now to the navigation. So let's see. Huh, seems to be having some issues with that for some reason. So I don't know exactly why. I'm gonna give it a screenshot of what I see, basically. So I'll paste in the screenshot and say, this is the nav I see. I'm logged in, but don't see an account button. So let's see if giving it more information helps here. So this is just kind of what, this is helpful, hopefully, so you can see what it's like to kind of debug with the AI and how to prompt it. All right, so for some reason, it's having trouble with this, but I'm gonna go ahead and skip that step. Let's go over to publish. And what I wanna do is deploy. So by clicking deploy, Lovable is going to automatically deploy using a subdomain on the Lovable domain. And if you want, you can add your own custom domain to it. But now I'm gonna click this link. And here we are on an actual web page on the internet that I could share with other people, and anyone could use it. And I can create a post. Here it's asking me to sign in. So let's create another account here. So I'm gonna click sign up, and let's go ahead and click sign up. There we go. So now I'm logged in. Again, for some reason, that account button is not showing up, which I'm sure we could debug with back and forth a little bit more. But I could create my own post. Second post, hello. Create the post, and here we go. So you can see the email. This one's Seth at NoCode.MBA, and this is Seth plus one at NoCode.MBA. So these are two different users here. So really cool to see. We can upvote as well, and it built in functionality so that you can only upvote once for each post. So it did that automatically. First comment, and I can comment as well, and upvote the comments also. So super cool. We built this in about 15 minutes, maybe. There's definitely a lot more that we could build if we wanted to work more on it with more time. But hopefully this gives you an idea of how easy it is to build a functioning app with a functioning backend database that also has account authorization. And you can publish it directly on the internet. And here I'm just showing you really quickly in Supabase. If you go to the table editor, you can see that we have the comment, posts, and profiles tables, and this data is getting saved to the actual database. So I hope that you found this helpful. Subscribe to our channel to get more videos like this. Go to some of our past videos to see more about how to build with tools like Lovable or Bolt or other no-code and AI tools that we have here on the channel. And check out nocode.mba to view our full in-depth tutorials covering how to build with AI and no-code tools in a lot more detail. I think you're really gonna like it if you liked this video. And also, leave a comment below and let us know what you wanna see next. What do you wanna see us build? What questions do you have about building with AI? Anything along those lines, let us know. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.